It's your boy TMKTJ the Motherland Kid. I'm back with another reaction video, and today we're going to react to the one and only MC Abdul, the pen and the sword. You already know. Before we get into it, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Let's get this channel to 1K, nigga. 1K, I mean, you like what I do? I mean, talk to me, man. Comment, like, subscribe, I mean, share. I mean, let me know what you want me to react to, man. You know what I'm trying to say? Yeah. Let's get into it, you know. Let's see. And a lot of people have been asking on the comments, like, is he alive? So I went and did research his last song, you know, and this is what I found, the pen and the sword. And like I said, this is not the type of music we used to about hip-hop and stuff. This is more of a, like, real-life situation. I'm not saying that all the music is not real-life situation, but this is, you know, politics. You know what I'm trying to say? Like, a different type of... Yeah, let's dive into it, man. You're gonna see what I'm trying to say. Holy. He coming in with the style, man. I remind him the pen is greater than the sword. He's trying to say, in my opinion, education is better than the wars, the fight. Let's just, you know, like, if anything, instead of going and ripping each other, taking, you know, what you can from the other person, how about you learn their culture? How about you learn how they got that? How about you learn how they became like that? How about you learn how, whatever, how they got to where they are? Instead of just ripping it from them, and it ends right there. You know, that's just my opinion, you know? Education we defend, it's gonna save the world. Word. Dreaming we unite together, save the world. Don't stop trying, we are humans in God's eyes. Education we defend. Wallahi, on God, we all humans in God's eyes. We are, not even that, we are all humans in the animal's eyes before we even go to God. Because look, all dogs are dogs. We're not going to sit here and be like, oh, this is... Yeah, it is that. But at the same time, all dogs are... All animals are animals. You know what I mean? And I think all animals looks at us like all humans. You know what I'm trying to say? We're the only ones sitting here trying to separate. This one's a this, this one's a that. This is black, this is white, this is Chinese. All that extra shh. You know what I'm trying to say? Damn, man. Save the world. Education is not just some privilege and right that every child deserves. God given that right come under threat. It must be defended. You think a lot of see what God. I'm sorry, there's gonna be a lot of pausing and a lot of talking. You know, it's a reaction video. You know, I'm just trying to put my opinion in and all that extra stuff. If you want to go and just listen to some, you know, I'll put the link down below, you know, and you can go just click there and then, or search MC Abdul, the pen and the sword, and you can listen to it in peace without me talking, without me pausing, nothing. You know what I'm trying to say? But yeah, let's see what I kind of miss on. Some privilege and right that every child deserves. Like I was saying, every kid deserve education, you know. I'm from a village where, like, the education still haven't reached, like, as it's supposed to. It's a lot of people that still don't know how to even write their name. They don't know how to do a lot of things in different languages and shit. But the education is really like some people say back home, they say, if you are not educated, you are a blind person. Like, basically, you don't know nothing because you educated, you learn, you can write for yourself, you can read, you can see. Not just in your language or your knowledge, you get to learn how others, you know, how other cultures are. Because if I go to England and read, it's in English, I can literally understand what's going on. And if I go to France and read French, I can understand what's going on. You know what I'm trying to say? Not just in my country, because we're humans. We're not just gonna, like, when you are able, you go somewhere else, like, where you don't know nothing, you know? So if you don't have education, you kind of stuck. You're like a rock, you know? You need somebody else. You know what I'm trying to say?
God-given that right come under threat. It must be defended. You think Allah will see what you're doing to his children? Who's been held accountable? Who is in charge, mister? He's when to his children. Threat. It must be defended. You think Allah will see what you're doing to his children? Who's been held accountable? He's saying you think God doesn't see what you're doing to his children? Allah means God. Just because he's saying Allah doesn't mean it means their God. Allah just is an Arabic word that means God. And I would suggest anybody to use Allah because Allah doesn't have a gender. It doesn't say God is, doesn't say like just or jazz, whatever you call it. You know, Allah means specific, the one creator, the most high. You know what I mean? It doesn't put gender in it to lower anybody's gender or all that extra stuff. And you know, like, let's not judge. Let's not let them get killed because they are Muslims or they are Gazas. As humans, let's look at them as humans and react as much as we can on social media or wherever to get access, to it reaches to the people that can snap a finger and for this stuff to stop. You know what I mean? Because this is wrong. Nobody deserves to die. We are in 2023. There should not be no war. There should not be no war.
Who is in charge, mister? These kids ain't got nothing to do with y'all business. You should be building more schools in our prisons. They ain't even make news in y'all city. He could have been a scholar. He dealing with different problems. Missile hit his home and crushed and killed his baba. We should be playing soccer or meeting up by lockers. He wanted to be a doctor.
You think you gonna sit here and think you wanna be a scientist, a doctor, a politician, or whatever when you got missiles hitting your crib? No. You think you wanna watch the World Cup, the basketball finals, the whatever sport you like? UFC, whatever, finals, when you got missiles hitting your house? No. All these children want is like be able to play on the streets, even if it's going to be barefooted. I had the privilege to play, and even though we were poor back in Africa, even though I was poor, whatever, we still had the privilege to get outside and play barefoot in the streets, soccer, and nobody bombarded nothing. We didn't have to worry about those things. Now I feel for them. Even though I was like, damn, I wish I had the nice shoes, the clips. I wish I was playing on the field, on a nice clean field where a glass is not gonna cut my foot or none of that stuff. You know what I mean? But now I appreciate that because these kids don't have that. That kid is on a wheelchair holding a ball. She can't play soccer because a missile hit her and paralyze her, man. Come on, man. And they have so much anger. And it's crazy that this kid, they still, it don't matter what they're going through, they still put God first. They still believe in God. They still asking for God. You know how quick, in this Western world, something happened to them, they turn into smoking, drinking, shooting up. They can't handle the issue. These people, these kids been going through this war for so long, and yet they still turn to God. Yet you don't see them shooting up, dying, or epidemic overdose. You know what I mean? And people over here are depressed, stressed because of what? Over what? Over what? Huh? These are the ones that should be really, really depressed. Not because you can't get the iPhone 15. Not because you can't get the iPad, the newest one. Not because you don't have the Dr. Dre Beats. Not because you don't have the PS5. All these children want to do is play sport on the streets without worrying about a missile hitting and killing everybody in that neighborhood. God, please forgive me for being ungrateful, man. Please.
I remind him that the pen is greater than the sword. I remind him every time it's greater than.
like I said earlier, but it's so much anger. But yet, he still knows the assignment. Yet, they still stay on the road. Let's just fight. Let's just stay fight. Just keep our land and be able to be us. Because what's going to happen is, like, as soon as these people lose their land, they got to follow somebody else's rules. You know what I mean? With that being said, they going to be changing a lot of things. A lot of rules going to be going away. They probably lose their belief, their religion, all their extra stuff, their education. And it cannot it's too late for that. Israel owning Palestine is too late. They cannot own it. Why? Because it's too much blood spilled. You know, even if you get like 1 month, 2 months where the Palestine or however you pronounce the name agree to be in that country, it's not gonna work, bro. It's always gonna be that hatred. Let these people free. Let them be themselves. That's all they want. And it's already gonna take them centuries, almost literally, to rebuild, unless the powerful countries have mercy on them and help them come back to life. Even that, the trauma, the pain, will never leave these people, man. We watching them live getting killed, bro. Subhanallah. Know how many times I pray for peace and peace, saying habits still get on my rug. You pray for peace, still gotta take actions. People held responsible for their actions. Until then, we gotta. So pray for peace and peace, saying habits still get on my rug. You pray for peace, still gotta take actions. People held responsible for their. And you wonder why they still going? Because you know Palestine is not a big country. They don't have the missiles, the big missiles. They don't have the drones. They don't have the USA or Russia military gears. They don't have that. Why you think they still standing? Because of God. God always gave them a chance. God is like, yes, he's not going to get down here and fight the war for them, but he's going to give them the courage. He's going to give them the little knowledge, whatever they need, you know, and he's going to give them the little support that they need. Now we are seeing this. And this has been going on for so long. Before I was born, before a lot of people was born. And it's still going on. And it's wrong. It's wrong. If they're the one was doing this to Israel, I would say it's wrong. If anybody is doing this to a country, I would say it's wrong. That's all I can say. I'm a human being. I cannot watch another human being get killed without my body squirming. Like, even though, like, if it's not self-defense. If these people kill, it's self-defense. But they're the one getting killed. They powerless. You know, yes, somebody come in and say war is both ways. Yes, war is both ways. But if I'm in my house chilling and somebody come, I'm going to defend myself. Does that mean I'm wrong for defending myself? Or are they wrong for coming to my land and trying to take it? Who's wrong? Let's be honest. Actions. Until then, we gotta stay active. We need change. That change needs to be data driven, accurate, comprehensive, and since we the victims, we deserve a voice in day-to-day decisions. And we can dig these generations out of these grave conditions.
My inspiration,
inshallah, the creator is gonna make things happen. Just keep pushing the pen. It's gonna come, overcome the sword. Inshallah. And I was about to say, whatchamacallit, his accent is so clear. Like, is he from here? Like, was he born here and went there? Because he doesn't have like a thick accent where you can't understand what he's saying. It's like so clear. You know what I'm trying to say? Like, I can't understand some people, but I could understand him clearly. Like he's just another dude from down the street. You know what I'm trying to say? Some people are not going to be able to understand me because I'm not from here. I grew up in Africa, you know? Like, I moved here like a couple of years ago. But, you know, like, you could still hear my accent. Like, it's heavy, you know? But him, I couldn't hear his accent. I might be wrong, though. You know what I'm trying to say? That was it. The pen and the sword. MC Abdul, you know, if I offend you, that's not my intention. I'm just trying to raise awareness through what's going on, what I can do. You know what I mean? It's good to give, like, I react, somebody else gonna see that, and like, even though you're not gonna pick a sword, or you're not gonna pick a gun, or you're not gonna pick anything, your prayer can help somebody else, like a child that want just education, a child that just wanna play soccer on the street, a child that wanna play basketball, whatever. Look at your life, or you see me sitting here having this privilege to sit here not worrying somebody is gonna kick this door, like, or like, not even kick the door, a missile is gonna hit this building or anything. Any child should have that privilege. Any child. We are in 2023. We are not at the age where, like, we need so much. Everything can be negotiated. You know what I mean? Like, if they want that, they can go negotiate and get what they want without having to kill children. Or they can listen to them and see why they cannot give them that and have a without nobody dying. Because I'm sure it's not just the Palestine people dying. I'm sure it's some Israelite that dying too. You know what I mean? This shouldn't be about religion anymore. This shouldn't be about colors anymore. It should just be like humans killing humans and humans dying from humans. I mean, a lot of some powerful people going to think, like, oh, that's just another way of depopulating the world without putting in the footwork. But at the same time, God created us. If God feel like the world need to be depopulated, he gonna depopulate as much as he wants. You know what I mean? It's not up to a human being to say, okay, it's time to depopulate. Let some people die in vain. You know, this should stop. You know what I'm trying to say? Because all this gonna do is, like, it's messed up, bro. There's nothing much to say, man. That was the MC Abdul Pan, the Sword. Before you leave, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Let's get this channel to 1K, nigga. 1K, I mean, you like what I do, I mean, subscribe, I mean, share, I mean, like, comment, talk to me, man. Let me know what you want me to react to, man. Let's go!